Good afternoon and welcome to St. Michael the Archangel Parish. Our celebrant today is Father Branson. Today we celebrate the 32nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Mass is being offered for the intentions of the people of St. Michael the Archangel Parish. For more information about our parish or volunteer activities, please head to our website at stmichaels77.org or see our Sunday bulletin. The Michaelettes Christmas Bazaar will be held on Saturday, November 18th from 10:30 to 2 p.m. Please pick up your raffle tickets after all Masses for great prizes. Come and see the various vendors, food trucks, the showcase of classic cars and motorcycles, and much more. The Humana van will be in the parking lot. Come visit and speak with Greg Garcia on health insurance after Mass. Please note, it is our custom not to leave Mass until the choir has finished singing. And as we prepare for Mass, let us silence our cell phones and observe a moment of silence.
Our processional hymn is Rain Down. Please stand.
Rain down, rain down, rain down your love on your people. Rain down, rain down, rain down your love, God of life. Faithful and true is the word of our God. All of God's works are so worthy of trust. God's mercy falls on the just and the right. Full of God's love is the earth. Rain down, rain down, rain down your love on your people. Rain down, rain down, rain down your love, God of life. We who revere and find hope in our God live in the kindness and joy of God's wing. God will protect us from darkness and death. God will not leave us to starve. Rain down, rain down, rain down your love on your people. Rain down, rain down, rain down your love, God of life.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Brethren,
let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison. Christ eleison. Kyrie eleison. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care, because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. O God, you are my God, whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts. Like the earth I parched, lifeless and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. thus have I gazed toward you in this sanctuary, to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. I will remember you upon my couch, and through the night watches I will meditate on you. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Halle, halle, hallelujah. Halle, halle, hallelujah. Halle, halle, hallelujah. Hallelujah,
disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was the long delay, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight there was a cry, "Behold the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, if you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you. We have two more Sundays after this of the year, church year. And then we get into Advent. And then we get into Christmas, which I'm always sad to see come because the days grow longer after Christmas. And that means the heat is coming. You have to know the signs. But anyway, because we're at the end of the church year, the readings start focusing in on end times and or the kingdom of heaven is like. And that's what Jesus says today in the gospel. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who didn't take their lamps. Five did, or they took the lamps, five didn't take oil, five did. Now, the wedding customs at the time of Jesus for the Jewish people were this. The parents of the bride, the parents of the groom, would look around as they were growing up for an eligible mate in the clan, which is the larger part of the tribe. You didn't want to marry outside the clan because each clan had its customs and it had a way of doing things. And you didn't want to marry outside the clan because you might get someone in there that didn't put jalapenos in their tamales like you wanted, and that was a mortal sin. So you wanted somebody in the clan. Then, when you finally picked somebody, one set of parents would go to the other set of parents and say, "Hey, look, what do you think about a marriage between your daughter, your son, my daughter, my son?" And if it was agreeable, then you started working towards that goal. The parents of the bridegroom would start planning a feast when it was time for the wedding. Today, the bride's father is expected to pay for everything. Back then, the groom's father did. So I don't know where the transition happened. But they would plan enough feast for a week. People would go to the wedding reception and they would eat and party for a week. It would last that long. Now, if you looked at the life in the villages, the women had to stay home, take care of the kids, fix the meals from scratch. You know, you had to kill the chicken in the morning and pluck it and gut it and on and on and on. You had to make the They had to make the masa and the fry bread and all this kind of stuff. So you had to start early in the morning. So their lives were more of a drudgery, staying in the same place all the time with almost nothing changing. That's why they liked to go down to the well to get water so they could see the other women and find out, "What did you find out's going on in the village that I don't know?" And so it was a very social occasion. But about every 5 years, sometimes 10, on average in villages, a wedding would happen. And everybody was psyched up and stoked for this wedding because of this feasting and the socializing and those kinds of things. Now, on the day of the wedding, the groom is working out a deal still with the bride's parents. See, the bride's parents are going to lose a valuable member of the household. There's going to be more cooking and cleaning and all of this for all the rest of the women in the household if she leaves and goes and lives with her husband in her in-law's house. So they have to have a dowry. The groom's family has to pay the bride's family money and goods to take the bride. Now, this negotiations of what kind of money, what kind of material things, what kind of gifts could go on all day long on the wedding. They had to still iron it out. So when Jesus said the bridegroom came at midnight, sometimes this happened because the negotiations weren't going well. But God helped people if they didn't finish those negotiations. Because you had a whole bunch of food and wine, you had all the village stocked up, and you came out and said, the wedding's off. You would be lynched. Because everybody's looking forward to it. So the bridegroom is the indicator of the wedding. Today, we all wait for the bride to walk up the aisle. Again, I don't know where the transition happened, but the groom just stands there. Before, the groom would go get the bride when everything was finally done and finalized, and he would walk down the street of the village. The people that were invited, if it was night, which it was, usually was, had torches to light the way. And these girls with lamps would light along the way for the bride and bridegroom. They'd walk along with them. And then everybody would go into the reception area, shut the gates so the people that weren't invited couldn't get in, and go on for a week. So we see these elements in our gospel. It was a very incredible affair. And then when it was over, everybody would start looking around saying, who's going to be married next? When can we have another party? So you can see it's kind of an expensive thing too. But we see in our gospel story, Jesus says, a wedding is like the kingdom of heaven. And we see this because the bride represents the church. Throughout this gospel, the church is represented by the bride. Jesus is the bridegroom. So we have those two. And the wedding is always seen as the unification of the two. Jesus unified with his church, his bride. The bride, the church, unified with Jesus Christ. And so they're going to this ceremony. Now, the foolish girls who don't have enough oil, because everybody fell asleep. Notice nobody gets in trouble for falling asleep. It's just about, do you have enough oil for your lamps? And the oil we're talking about, of course, is olive oil. That's what they had to burn. So the five that don't have it, they're representing the fact that the oil is the Holy Spirit. The oil is our commitment. The oil is faith. They don't have it. They have to go pick it up at the... It's midnight. They're going to go knocking on a door, waking somebody up, if he's even home. He might be at the wedding. And then they're out of luck. But the five wise ones have the Holy Spirit. They have faith. And they follow Jesus and the church into the wedding feast, which is indicative and representative of heaven. So Jesus is saying, look, there are going to be people that are left out of heaven. There are going to be people that go into heaven. Currently, we have the view in a lot of places, a lot of people have the view that everybody's going to heaven and nobody's going to go to hell. And yet Jesus says time and time again and gives us examples that, yes, people are going to go to hell by their own choice. Notice, the girls chose not to have oil. They chose not to be part of the wedding feast. They made that decision on their own. The same thing when we die and have the judgments, we're going to see our life go before us, and we're going to tell God, I deserve heaven, I deserve hell. Now, when we die and we have the particular judgment, which happens right after we die, we can say, I deserve purgatory. But once the general judgment happens, when you stand before every person that's ever lived, there's only two choices, heaven and hell. So Jesus is showing us that the kingdom of heaven has two choices. And he's saying, be prepared. Be prepared with your faith. Be prepared with the grace of the Holy Spirit in your life. Many Catholic bloggers today end their blogs with one statement. Go to confession. Make sure you're ready. The other thing is, study your faith. Read the Bible. Read the catechism. Be aware of what it is to be Catholic. Be aware of what it is to be partaking of the sacraments. Don't stay away. Don't make the decision to say, oh, I don't need the church. I don't need this. I don't need that. Because death comes all too fast. And that's the other thing Jesus is telling us about. Be prepared. Because you don't know when you're going to die. In this day and age, with our cars, our motorcycles, our airplanes, death could happen instantly. There's no time to get a Catholic priest for last rites like there used to be in the old days when the only thing that could happen to you is you fall off the horse and hit your head. Today, it comes instantly, and then you don't have a decision. You don't have a choice. So be prepared. Be like the Boy Scouts. Always prepared. Boy Scouts say, be prepared for anything. And you and I need to be prepared for eternal life. Because after all, that's what we're here for, and that's what we're preparing for. Eternal life, because that's our goal. Not to have the most toys, not to have the most money, but eternal life. So be prepared, have oil in your lamps, so that you can enjoy the wedding feast that lasts forever. God bless you. I believe.
One God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and he became a man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The gospel message reminds us to be wise and vigilant. Christ will come again. As we wait for him, we pray for the world he has redeemed.
That the church may read the signs of the times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That universities and other institutes of education may be centers of wisdom amidst the follies of this world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying may look to Christ with hope and penitent trust, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be helped by the prayers of Mary, Seat of Wisdom, and Mother of Good Counsel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died will be with the Lord forever, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of time and eternity, grant the petitions we make as we wait for the coming of Christ, your gift of eternal wisdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is My Soul is Thirsting.
soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. O God, you are my God, and I will always praise you. In the shadow of your wings I cling to you, and you hold me high. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. Through the day you walk with me, all the night your love surrounds me. To the glory of your name I lift my hands, I sing your praise. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, my Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. I will never be afraid, for I will not be abandoned. Even when the road grows long and weary, your love will rescue me. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, whom you have raised up Jesus from the dead. We hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, holy angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and work of the Holy Spirit, give life to all things and make them holy. Never cease to gather a people to yourself, from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, in the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with this Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May make of us an eternal offering to you, so we obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. With this sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. Your compassionate, merciful Father, gather yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, all are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind amends to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, to bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace, my child.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, you take away the sins of the world. Dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Many the gifts, many the people, many the hearts that yearn to belong. Let us be servants to one another, making your kingdom come. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church gathered today. Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church gathered today. Shine in your church gathered today.
In our parish tonight, we are having an institution of a new organization into the parish roster. And these ladies, you may have noticed, look like they're in white. Because they are in white, right? I half expect to see the veil for the sisters back in the day, okay? The Catholic Daughters of America, back in the 30s, the Knights of Columbus founded them as a female counterpart so that the women could be involved in charity work too. Raising money was essentially that. So tonight, they're going to be instituted right now because they're going to be a part of the parish. We ask them to please stand. Those of you in front of them, don't get all tensed up. They're not going to do anything to you, okay? Mighty God, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit down upon and bless these women. These are going to be these Catholic daughters in their new court in the state of Arizona, the United States of America. We ask you to watch over them, protect them, guide them always. We ask you to make them remember that they are true unity and charity members and doers and givers. Mighty God, we ask for peace within their organization. We ask for peace within the parish as we all adjust to having this new organization. Watch over them, bless them in a special way to give them the guidance they need to work through the charity and unity so be able to help the parish and any other organization they wish to help. And in other parishes, they cook a lot. So hopefully we'll see some good things coming out of the kitchen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure, and those your heavenly power has entered, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. To you, O blessed Joseph.
Our recessional hymn is Soon and Very Soon.
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. No more crying there, we are going to see the King. No more crying there, we are going to see the King. No more crying there, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. No more dying there, we are going to see the King. No more dying there, we are going to see the King. No more dying there, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King.